Round 8 is still going on out there in the Superstars Game Center 5K, but not for this gentleman next to me. Alex Alepin has already secured his spot in the top 32. Drew your way in, huh?
Oh, yeah. Well, I mean, you know, when the math works out, the math works out, right?
I mean, are you sure? Because I know those judges, they won't commit to anything.
They will definitely be put my name last on the announcement. They always do. They gotta love me.
In no particular order, except for Alex Alepin in last place.
Is always in last.
By the skin of his teeth.
Exactly.
Sure.
I could be first seed going in, no matter what they're announcing me last.
So how are these last few rounds since we talked to you?
I mean, it's been going fine. I crushed somebody and then drew unintentionally with a Merfolk player and then ID'd. So. You know, the last round was a little long. We had a 10-minute deck check instruction, so we were sitting in those chairs for probably about an hour 15. It's just a long time.
How much more tense does it get on your side of the table, as you perceive the other player on their side of the table, when you start playing on the bubble, when it's, you know, must win or, you know, must tie just to get in there?
I mean, for me, it's all about the crowd. I just love the crowd. I love people watching. And some people get more nervous with it, and it's just, for me, it's more fun. I mean, you make more of a game out of it. People, you know, tend to enjoy the matches more when, you know, people are just having fun playing a game as opposed to dead serious, you know, silence. And
I mean, is that a way to also rattle some people, especially if they're not used to that crowd, if they're uncomfortable watching people?
You know, if you can see that the guy's shaking, you know, you just show them your comfort in the level and or your comfort level of, in playing, and then, you know, it kind of throws them off.
Definitely.
So it's fun.
You play a lot of Magic. You're here pretty often. You're familiar with, you know, the local players here.
Mm-hmm.
How many of those players do you see at the top tables right now? Is it more people coming down from like Sacramento, from further away?
I mean, I'd probably say 50-50. The people that I see regularly do come down from Sacramento and that stuff. So
sure,
it would be more like the people that I, you know, generally play with or generally notice at larger tournaments like PTQs or whatever that I would probably see at the top table.
How does that make you feel? I mean, if you kind of habitually see people at the top tables, you've got to assume they're good. Maybe you're at the top table sitting across from a stranger. I mean, is there a difference there, or is it just all the same crush?
To me, it seems like when I'm playing somebody that I know, I definitely try to have more fun with it. You know, that way, no matter what, there's no hard feelings at the end of the match.
Sure.
But, you know, when you're playing against a stranger, it's a little different, unless, you know, you both, you know, get to a certain level of understanding that it's going to be a fun game. That, you know, we're here on a Saturday playing a game for, you know, some money, whatever. But in the end, it's just a game, so, you know.
How do things change going into the top 32? The REL level goes up to professional. Do things have to tighten up there?
Of course. You always have to tighten up, and, you know, especially when it gets down to playing for more and more money. I mean, you know, everything goes silent. Everybody's, you know, deliberate in with their moves, and, you know, hopefully you catch people off guards, and, you know, they just rattle a little bit.
Is there more of an edge? I mean, you've been day two of GP numerous times. You've played under that professional REL before. A lot of people out there, and I suspect a lot of people in the top 32 haven't. I mean, do you think that gives you an edge? Do you think that?
Well, it has to, right? I mean, experience definitely can, you know, dictate behavior, I guess. But in terms of what I'm expecting everybody to play their best. I mean, I'm not really expecting anybody to just be god-awful and go, you know, with an 8-round grinder
sure.
or 6-round grinder
right.
and make it
right.
in. I mean, it's a pretty tough, like, level of tournament, like, in terms of, like, the rounds that are played in each one.
Especially playing 5-color control, I mean, it gets tiring.
It's just grueling. Yeah. And then, I mean, at least now you got a 2-hour break for dinner while people are trying to grind it out, so.
Nice. You know. Yeah, exactly. I mean, those five that are grinding it out right now for those five spots.
Exactly.
They're going to come into it, boom, boom, boom. You get to relax.
Well, I mean, unless they're on a, you know, somewhat of a roll, right? I mean.
Yeah, I guess. I mean, they come in hot or something. Okay,
yeah, but
sure.
It's kind of grind. It's kind of a grueling day, especially if you ran the last chance.
Definitely coming straight through. Well, awesome. Congratulations making the top 32 pin.
Thank you.
Especially after, you know, last night you play, a little disheartening, you don't make it. You come in today, play a much longer day of Magic with a much more difficult deck, and boom, here you are, top 32. Either way, it's all the same, right?
Exactly. I mean, you know, it's just money out of my pocket.
Thanks a lot, Alex.
Not a problem.